When an Army of the Dead star got called out, Zack Snyder called on Tig Notaro to save a role. Tig Notaro filming a scene for Army of the Dead on a green screen. Photo: Scott Garfield, Netflix. Tig Notaro filming a scene for Army of the Dead on a green screen. Photo: Scott Garfield, Netflix. During the weeks Tig Notaro spent working on Army of the Dead, Zack Snyder's new zombie heist movie, one thought kept running through her head: how on earth did telling jokes lead me to this moment? It was Notaro's first action gig, and the 50-year-old was stepping into a role originally performed by fellow comedian Chris D'Elia, who had recently been accused of pursuing multiple teenage girls. The allegations against D'Elia had surfaced in June 2020, and within weeks, his agency, CAA, had dropped him and Netflix canceled his deal for an unscripted prank show. D'Elia continues to deny the allegations. By that time, Snyder was deep into post-production on Army of the Dead, which follows a team of mercenaries led by Dave Bautista that infiltrates zombie-ridden Las Vegas to recover millions of dollars from a casino vault. The comic played a supporting role as a wisecracking helicopter pilot named Peters. In August, Snyder announced that he would digitally erase D'Elia from the movie and reshoot his part with Notaro. It wasn't the first time an actor had been replaced in post-production after being accused of sexual misconduct. In 2017, Ridley Scott spent 9 days reshooting Kevin Spacey's scenes in All the Money in the World with Christopher Plummer. The same year, the animated series Gravity Falls redubbed a character originally voiced by Louis C.K., a former friend and collaborator of Notaro's. Snyder's task was more demanding. It would have been a logistical nightmare to bring back Army of the Dead's cast for reshoots during a pandemic, so Notaro would have to film almost all of her scenes in front of a green screen with no other actors in sight, and Snyder's team would then edit them into the existing footage. The director wouldn't reveal how much this process tacked onto the budget, but he did say it was cheaper than creating the movie's CGI zombie tiger. Notaro and Snyder look back on the convoluted filming process with a mixture of awe and relief. "We kind of knew what we were getting into," says Snyder, "but had no idea how hard it would be." When Snyder's casting director mentioned Notaro for the role, the director recalls, "My brain just went, wait. Tig. Yes. That's it. Then, I'm like, do you think she would do this, though? I was so baffled," Notaro says of learning Snyder wanted her for the part. "I felt like there was some sort of misunderstanding." As an actor, Notaro had almost always played a variation on herself. The closest she had come to something like her role in Army of the Dead was in the series Star Trek: Discovery, where her stunt work was limited to falling onto a mattress.